Oh, it's 4-0 against Millwall. Doesn't get worse than that, does it?
It's appalling, mate. It's much worse than last week. Much worse. We just didn't show any fight. Even at the end of the game, none of the players come over. Josh Murphy was the closest to come to the edge of the 18. It's just...
There was booing for a lot of the second half. Do you agree with that?
Russell Martin, no. I think Marcel Frank had a much worse game. James Husband was shocking. I don't think Martin put it wrong. Maybe third goal, blocked the shot, but overall I think it's harsh to boo him.
You look at James Husband, he's been in there for the majority of games now. He's been woeful in every one, yet he's still not dropped. Why?
We ain't got a full-in replacement for him, mate. We've got Steeperman, but he came here as a central midfielder who can play left-back. We haven't got another left-back. We need to sign another left-back.
Where do we go from here? I mean, there was a lot of optimism at the start of the season. And I mean, the defeats have been poor. We've had a decent win against QPR, but that's it. I mean, where do we go?
Well, I think people saying it takes time. It doesn't take time to play good football, decent football. International break comes, get closer back in, sort out the defence a bit. That's all. It's the link up between defence to midfield. I think bringing another midfielder, I mean, Teddy didn't really provide much. I think it's a poor decision. Second half, we just shut up shop, not interested in going and at least trying to get a goal back.
I mean, the defence was woeful today, but once again, you were there at Villa, you saw it, the midfield, it was nowhere to be seen, was it?
We just have no link-up. We have no link-up play between the midfield and the attack, and that's what lets us down. Because like today, we bring on three defensive players. I know we're losing 3-0, we're probably not going to go to win the game, but bring on three defensive players.
Going forwards as well, Madison, I mean, Wes was good at times, but he didn't seem to release the ball when he needed to. Oliveira was poor. I mean, it doesn't fill you with confidence, does it?
No, Wes can't play week in, week out, and that's exactly why. Against teams like Millwall, who are strong, physical, he's just nowhere in the game. Madison, maybe a bit more, as he's been in the Scottish League, but overall, they're just getting muscled out of the game. I think Stephen Naismith might have suited that more.
International break now. Is that the break we need?
Well, we needed some break. I don't know, we just need to come back. We need to come back stronger. I don't know what Farke's going to do, but he needs to shore up the defence. It's the same with every manager, same with Neil, same with Neil Adams. It's just, he needs to shore up the defence. Until we don't get that sorted, we're not going to go anywhere.
I mean, in terms of the transfers we brought in, Zimmerman, Franke, you look at the others, 10 transfers. They're all unknown players, and I think there was a bit of excitement because of that. Can you now see that these are German 4th division players trying to compete in what is a very competitive football league?
Yes, so obviously, if you look at other teams, Aston Villa, for example, I know they've got Dom Terry, it's a big wage bill, but at least bring in a championship defender who knows what the league is about. I mean, it really showed today that they're not used to it. I mean, you've got Steve Morrison, an ageing striker, and McGregor, but they just run them ragged all game. There's no leadership, and I think that's why he's kept Martin in that defence, but as soon as you've taken him off, they look all over the place. No one quite knows where they are. Same as Aston Villa, floating players, not doing much, not releasing balls. And it's just basic football that we're not doing right.
That's not bad. Top man. Cheers, bud. Top man.